Good morning everybody and welcome to the Ditton Works YouTube channel. Today I'm going to talk about the letter M. M for musical fidelity, M for Martin Colloms, M for monitor audio, M for Robin Marshall. I'll link this all up in a minute, but basically I've got a pair of speakers which you can pick up very cheap and they're not particularly well known, but what I want to discover is, are they not particularly well known because they're not very good, or are they not well known and they're a little audio gem? Because there's some indicators here that these should be good. So what have we got? We've got the Musical Fidelity MC-2, and they're called the MC-2 because Martin Colloms designed these. Now Martin Colloms, I would know him for predominantly as a magazine hi-fi reviewer, and he's very good at that. But before that, he actually started and was this first chief technical guy for monitor audio, which there's an interesting link here that is a monitor audio tweeter. The Robin Marshall part of the letter M this week is that tweeter looks remarkably similar to the first MD, the metal dome tweeter used in monitor audio speakers, which Robin Marshall designed. So we've got some good strong indicators that these are potentially a well-made pair of speakers. So cabinet-wise, well braced. On the back, inset rear baffle. Now that's something you'd normally see, or I first saw, on Wharfdale 505.2s, 506, they've got that inset rear baffle. And that was a Graham Bank design, which when he left Wharfdale to return to Celestion, you'll notice things like Celestion SL6S and onwards have that inset rear baffle. It stiffens up the cabinet. So that's an interesting feature. We've got an inset rear baffle. These are rear ported, that's nothing unusual. By-wire terminals, solid cabinet. This monitor audio tweeter, and what looks like a very decent and well-made bass driver. These normally have quite horrible blue decals here that match the sort of musical fidelity famous amplifiers in the day, like the A1. These ones don't have it, and I thought perhaps somebody had painted these, but no, some of them don't have it. There's a veneered pair on eBay right now that don't have the decals either, and in all honesty, they look a lot better without the decals. Okay, let's dive inside this speaker and see what it's actually made of. I'm pretty sure that's a monitor audio tweeter. It looks very, very similar, and it has got some interesting features, like I said. So let's see if all of those interesting features and the design work of Martin Colloms has actually made a decent speaker. Let's have a look. Okay, I've started taking the MC2s apart. The keen-eyed will notice that the tweeters are offset. So if you check the line there, it's not in line with there and not in line there. And I quite like that. That means that you have the option of running left or right tweeter out or tweeter in. So let's continue taking these apart and we'll see what we can find inside there. Okay, so we've disassembled one. There's quite a large amount of wadding inside these. Couple of pieces I found interesting. There's a date in there, 1990. These were reviewed in 1988 at $595, which if we convert the money is about £330. Interesting things, figure of eight brace. So not only have these got the inset rear baffle, which is pretty much something that Wharfdale and Celestion did many years earlier, they've also got that figure of eight brace, which is another Celestion idea. Now, I thought this looked remarkably like the monitor audio tweeter, but upon investigation, that 25TAF/GMF, presumably the MF is for musical fidelity, made in Norway, that's not the monitor audio tweeter. I would imagine that's probably... I've had to interrupt my own video of these being disassembled because I realised something after I put them back together. This is actually a Sears tweeter. And when I look back at some pictures, it seems to be that there is another version of these MC2s or an earlier version. I'm going to attach a couple of pictures of the different version and you can see the screw holes are slightly further apart on the pictures. That is definitely the monitor audio tweeter. And I'll put a picture of the R852MDs, which is the same tweeter.
I will look that up later, but that's not at all what I thought it was going to be. Base unit, that's a pressed steel chassis with not the largest magnet, and not easy to see in there, a pretty small spider. I would say that's not the highest quality driver at all. Let's bring the camera inside. So down in there, we've got a reasonable crossover. Let's see if I can keep that still. With what looks like polycaps. There we go. Yeah, so pretty well thought out crossover. Closer on that tweeter. There's your port up there. This did have quite a lot of wadding inside, so it's a well damped cabinet. But I would say this design is quite a copy from various other things that have gone before. I don't know how much influence Martin Colloms actually had on these, and I would say these were probably built to match a system. I don't know, there's not an awful lot of information about these, but the next thing to do really is put them back together and have a listen to see how they sound.
Spinning wheel like a snowball down a mountain, or a carnival balloon like a carousel that's burning, running rings around the moon like a clock whose hands are sweeping past the minutes of its face. And the world is like an apple whirling silently in space, like the circles that you find in the windmills of your mind.
Something that I need to mention, a couple of shout outs to some people. So Dynaco Man, thank you very much for your comments on my previous videos, I really appreciate that. And to Michael Yates of Budget Hi-Fi Review, also has commented, and his channel's well worth a watch if you're looking for something in the sort of entry level budget. You can get some fantastic stuff, sub 100, sub £200, and he really nails that. On the same sort of note, I'm actually going to try and get these to Michael at some point so he can do a review, because I think these fall into that category that he so well reviews. So when it's physically possible, I'll get these down to Michael, and it'll be interesting to see what he thinks of them. It's always nice to hear a different person's perspective. They're on a different system in a different room. So I think that'll be worthwhile doing. So I'll do my best to get them to you, Michael. My thoughts on these. They're pretty laid back, they're quite polite. It's blown me away that that's not the monitor audio tweeter. I was absolutely convinced it was going to be, but it's Sias. And I hope you'll be able to see on the pictures that I put in the video interruption section that the screw holes are further apart, and also the lead wires come down onto the cone. The ones with the decals, I reckon they're the early version. And they might just be the ones Martin Colloms did. Maybe these are a Mark II. I honestly don't know. I don't know much about these. But that is definitely not the monitor audio tweeter. So whether they sound different, I don't know. I haven't got the other pair to do an A-B comparison. But I've always had a lot of respect for Sias. I think they make a very good tweeter. And in this configuration, they're quite rolled off. They're not harsh. They're not bright. They're not shrill. They're pretty good. They're quite rolled off. You get a nice amount of detail, but it's not harsh. There's a little bit of mid-range coloration, but not too much. That's suggesting the cabinet is quite well made, and with the inset rear baffle, the figure of eight bracing, I'm not surprised that there's not a lot of coloration. I think what lets these down, to be honest with you, is this bass driver. I think small magnet, small spider, not particularly big voice coil. It's not a powerful bass unit. The low end is there, but it's... they don't time particularly well. It's almost like the band is having a bit of an off day. it's not really possible for the music to be mistimed because that's etched into the recording, but some speakers certainly present music in a kind of time-delayed fashion, and something like Celestian DL8s are a little bit like that. That it's not they're lazy, it's almost like the drummer's having a bit of an off day. But they're not too bad, they're not too bad at all. I think for £100, which is what you can get something like this for now, and there is a nice veneered pair which look a little bit better than these black ones, for about £100. I'm going to do a bit more research on these because I'd love to hear what the Monitor Audio Tweeter ones sound like. I'd have to put up with the horrible blue decals, but it's got to be worth a listen if I can find a pair at the right price. Quite a large cabinet, they're pretty big, they're not too far off the size of my Spendors, so that would put them in the category of large two-way stand mount speakers. But I honestly think, for the money, they're not too bad. I think somebody would be quite pleased to have these as an upgrade from, you know, a pair of speakers that come with a hi-fi system, which interestingly is what I thought these were, but I think they're a little bit better than that. There's certainly been some serious thought gone into the design. Whether that all ties up together, I would say a company that's renowned for making speakers like these, certainly a lot better. But for a company that doesn't specialize in speakers, Musical Fidelity didn't do a bad job. I think Martin Colloms' input has certainly turned something that was probably not fantastic, but has made it pretty good. So I've got to give credit to Martin Colloms, not only for all of his reviews over the years, but his input, and bearing in mind he did work for Monitor Audio, he does know what he's talking about. He did actually assist Celestian on finding the faults with the very first Aerolam cabinets. So that's down to Martin Colloms as well. So he's a clever bloke, he is an engineer. So kudos to him. I think anybody who found a pair of these at the right price would probably be quite pleased. Anyway, that's the Ditton Works review for today. I hope you've enjoyed it. Sorry for the interruptions, but I was convinced that was Monitor Audio. And with all things, you don't know until you take it apart. All right, guys, take care.